Hello friends, welcome back to EduBridge IAS. This is Vishal Singh. Today we are going to continue with the second part of the first unit in our art and culture series, that is prehistoric paintings. If you remember, in the last video we had covered the definition of prehistory, the discovery of major prehistoric art sites, the significance of prehistoric art, the types of prehistoric art, a case study on Lakhudiyar, and a discussion on the iconic Bhimbetka cave complex and its paintings during the Upper Paleolithic Age. In this video, we will continue this discussion beginning with the Mesolithic paintings at Bhimbetka. Now, the Mesolithic Age is considered to be the most important phase for prehistoric art in the entire subcontinent, and the same is true for Bhimbetka as well. The largest number of paintings have been found in Bhimbetka belonging to this period. The number of themes multiply, but the paintings are smaller in size. So, yani ki, the number of themes which have been shown, they have increased. Now, not only hunting and dancing or large animals are covered, but mundane daily life activities including family life and burial scenes are also shown. The scenes of gathering of food, preparing of food, feeding, etc. They are also depicted. The animal figures predominate at the paintings during the Mesolithic period. So, ज़्यादातर paintings animals की हैं. And one particular shelter known as the Zurok shelter got its name because of the predominance of animal figures in that cave. Total 29 species of animals depict किए गए हैं, both large and small. Either they have been depicted as part of hunting scenes or without humans, that means on their own in the wild. A unique feature about prehistoric paintings in India, Mesolithic paintings in India, that no snakes have been shown anywhere. It probably points towards a cultural taboo against the depiction of snakes. Right, moving forward, some composite animals have also been depicted, such as an animal with the body of a boar, snout of a rhino, underlip of an elephant, and the horns of a buffalo. So you can look at this figure on your right, and this is a polychrome composite boar from Bhimbetka. It has the horns of a buffalo, the snout of a rhino, underlip of an elephant and body of a boar. So, is tarah ke animals bhi dikhaye gaye hain. Acha, kuch paintings mein animals ko humans chase kar rahe hain aur kuch paintings mein animals humans ko chase kar rahe hain. So, you can look at this painting and over here a huge boar or beast is chasing a very small human figure. Acha, some paintings show fear of animals while others show love and tenderness towards them. तो फियर तो हमको इस पेंटिंग में देखने के लिए मिल गया. द पेंटिंग ऑन इट्स राइट शोज अ फैमिली प्रिपेयरिंग फूड इन विच अ पिग इज बीइंग फेड बाय सम ऑफ द मेंबर्स ऑफ दैट फैमिली. सो दिस शोज लव एंड टेंडरनेस. अच्छा, अ थिंग टू नोट इज दैट एनिमल्स हैव बीन डिपिक्टेड इन अ नेचुरलिस्टिक मैनर बट ह्यूमंस हैव बीन डिपिक्टेड स्टाइलिस्टिकली. तो ह्यूमंस के स्टिक फिगर्स हैं बट एनिमल्स के वेरी नेचुरलिस्टिक रियल लाइफ लाइक फिगर्स हैं. यू कैन लुक एट दिस बाइक्रोम बुल फाउंड एट Jaura, very naturalistic. The way that women and men were depicted was also very different. Men have been shown as matchstick figures while women have been shown having fuller forms or fuller figures. Men have been shown wearing loincloths only, whereas women have been shown both clothed and in the nude. Men have been shown with loose hair while women have been shown with braided hair. Men are mostly shown hunting while women have been shown gathering and preparing food. So this probably points towards a division of labor based on gender. However, we cannot be very sure if that is actually what it meant. Now, coming to the hunters have been shown either in groups or alone using composite tools such as barbed spears, pointed sticks, bows, arrows, traps, and snares. So, what are these composite tools? These are complex tools in which more than one component is used. So, the characteristic stone tool technology of the Mesolithic period was known as microlith. Micro means small and lith is stone. So, the stone tool technology was small stone technology. This means that these stone tools were less than 5 cm in size. Now, such small stone tools were probably mostly used for hunting purposes. How? They were attached to the ends of a wooden shaft in order to make spears and arrows, or attached to the end of a stick in order to make a digging stick, etc. तो इस तरह के कॉम्पोजिट टूल्स मीजोलिथिक पीरियड की पेंटिंग्स में देखने के लिए मिलते हैं, जहां पे एरोज और स्पीयर्स के ऊपर माइक्रोलिथ्स अटैच किए हुए हैं। यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर दैट ड्यूरिंग दिस पीरियड मैन डिड नॉट हैव द नॉलेज ऑफ मेटल, तो यानी कि यहाँ पे कोई भी मेटल टूल्स नहीं देखने के लिए आपको मिलेंगे। इज दैट क्लियर? राइट, मूविंग फॉरवर्ड, बोथ सिंपल एज वेल एज elaborate clothes have been shown along with accessories. Now if you go back to the previous slide, you will find that these two hunters have been shown wearing a very elaborate headdress, and this one has a painted face mask as well, right? Now the ornaments included necklaces, bangles, wristbands, elbow bands, knee bands, etc. Another very important feature of the Mesolithic paintings at Bhimbetka is the use of एक्सरे पेंटिंग। एक्सरे पेंटिंग्स मतलब बॉडी के इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स भी पेंटिंग्स में दिखाए जाते हैं, इंक्लूडिंग अ फीटस। इफ यू लुक एट दिस पेंटिंग, यू विल फाइंड दैट इट इज अ फैमिली सीन, जहाँ पे एक प्रेग्नेंट वुमन है, फूड इज बीइंग प्रिपेयर्ड एंड द चाइल्ड इज ईटिंग इन द बैकग्राउंड। इफ यू लुक क्लोजली एट द फिगर ऑफ द प्रेग्नेंट वुमन, यू विल फाइंड दैट अ फीटस हैज ऑल्सो बीन शोन, राइट? अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस, कम्युनिटी सीन्स ऑल्सो बिकेम कॉमन, सच एज फैमिली सीन्स, community dances and burial scenes. So this is a family scene, this is a scene of a community dance, and this one is a burial scene. Both the young and the old have been depicted equally, right? Some drawings may also indicate conflict between tribes. So conflict ko symbolically yahan pe dikhaya gaya hai. Achha, hand and fist and fingerprints similar to the present day prints made for good fortune have also been found. These handprints were mostly done in the एंड स्टेंसिल टेक्निक, राइट? तो क्या होता था कि हाथ पत्थर पे रख देते थे और उसके ऊपर से पेंट लगा देते थे, राइट? सो इट फॉर्म्ड अ नेगेटिव इमेज ऑफ द हैंड। अच्छा, मोनोक्रोम, बाइक्रोम एंड पॉलीक्रोम पेंटिंग्स हैव बीन फाउंड। मोनोक्रोम पेंटिंग्स मतलब पेंटिंग्स डन इन वन कलर, बाइक्रोम टू कलर्स एंड पॉलीक्रोम मल्टीपल कलर्स। सुपर इम्पोजिशन वॉज ऑल्सो सीन ड्यूरिंग दिस फेज एट भीमबेटका। एट सम प्लेसेस मोर देन 20 डिफरेंट लेयर्स ऑफ पेंटिंग्स हैव बीन शोन एग्जिस्टिंग ओवर ईच अदर। अच्छा, नाउ सम ऑफ द इंटरप्रिटेशंस, देयर सीम्स टू हैव बीन अ डिवीजन ऑफ लेबर बेस्ड ऑन जेंडर, ये हम ऑलरेडी डिस्कस कर चुके हैं। थिंग टू नोट कि यहाँ पे मीजोलिथिक पीरियड में कोई पॉटरी नहीं देखने को मिलती है। क्यों? क्योंकि मीजोलिथिक पीरियड में पॉटरी एग्जिस्ट करती ही नहीं थी। व्हेन डिड पॉटरी फर्स्ट अपियर? ड्यूरिंग द नियोलिथिक पीरियड। व्हाई डिड इट अपियर? बिकॉज मैन फेल्ट द नीड फॉर स्टोरेज। व्हाट डिड ही नीड टू स्टोर? द एग्रीकल्चरल सरप्लस दैट ही वॉज क्रिएटिंग। तो मैन स्टार्टेड प्रैक्टिसिंग एग्रीकल्चर फ्रॉम द नियोलिथिक एज ऑनवर्ड्स। तो जब उसका हार्वेस्ट होता था तो ग्रेन्स को स्टोर करने के लिए कोई यूटेंसिल चाहिए होता था। फॉर दैट पर्पज ही स्टार्टेड मेकिंग पॉटरी। तो देर इज नो क्वेश्चन ऑफ द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ पॉटरी ड्यूरिंग द मीजोलिथिक पीरियड, एंड हेंस इट इज नॉट फाउंड ओवर हियर। अच्छा, सम पेंटिंग्स एंड एंग्रेविंग्स माइट ऑल्सो सजेस्ट रिचुअलिस्टिक एंड कल्टिक सिग्निफिकेंस। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, देर आर सम लार्ज पेंटिंग्स एट भीमबेटका जिनको कई लोगों ने एक साथ मिलकर बनाया होगा, एंड दिस प्रोबेबली टेल्स यू दैट उसका कोई रिचुअलिस्टिक या कल्टिक सिग्निफिकेंस था। अच्छा, मोस्ट ऑफ द पेंटिंग्स कम फ्रॉम साइट्स और केव्स विच वर इनहैबिटेड बाय द पीपल, लेकिन कुछ ऐसे स्टोन्स और केव्स हैं जहाँ पे लोग नहीं रहते थे, वहाँ पे भी पेंटिंग्स बनी हुई हैं। तो दीज वर ऑल्सो प्रोबेबली रिचुअलिस्टिक और कल्टिक पेंटिंग्स बिकॉज दीज साइट्स मस्ट हैव बीन कंसिडर्ड सेक्रेड। अच्छा, इन दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट, अ शैटर्ड सर्कुलर प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ सैंडस्टोन रबल found at a place called Baghor in Madhya Pradesh, having concentric triangles painted in different shades from red to reddish-brown color has also been found. Thing to note over here that it belonged to the Upper Paleolithic period and not the Mesolithic period. लेकिन हम religious या cultic paintings discuss कर रहे थे तो यहाँ पर मैंने इसको रखा हुआ है। तो क्या मिला है यहाँ पर? एक circular platform जिसके कई सारे टुकड़े हो चुके हैं और इसके ऊपर अलग अलग shades में concentric ट्राइंगल्स बनाए गए हैं। सो हाउ डू वी नो दैट इट हैड सम रिचुअल सिग्निफिकेंस और रिलीजियस सिग्निफिकेंस? क्योंकि बागोर जो कि कैमूर हिल्स में है, दैट दीज हिल्स आर प्रेजेंटली इनहैबिटेड बाय द कोल एंड बागिया ट्राइब्स हु वर्शिप सिमिलर ट्राइंगुलर स्टोन्स एंड मेक सिमिलर सर्कुलर रबल प्लेटफॉर्म्स। ऑलराइट, सो लेट अस टॉक अबाउट द पेंटिंग्स एट भीमबेटका ड्यूरिंग द कैल्कोलिथिक एज। Now the paintings of Bhimbetka of the Calcolithic age give concrete evidence of contact between the cave dwellers at Bhimbetka and the settled agricultural communities of Malwa, which were Calcolithic people. How do we know that such a contact existed? On the basis of what has been shown in the paintings. So these paintings bear some common motifs. So the paintings of both the Malwa communities as well as the Bhimbetka community have some common motifs which have been depicted. The pottery of the Malwa culture has also been shown in the Bhimbetka paintings. In addition to this, metal tools belonging to the Malwa culture have also been depicted in the Bhimbetka paintings. So therefore, we can say for certain that these people were in contact with each other. What was the purpose of this contact? They exchanged goods with each other. However, during this period, the paintings became lifeless and artificial. They lost their earlier vividness and vitality. Further, some paintings suggest animal domestication. So the evidence of animal domestication becomes visible in Bhimbetka's paintings from the Chalcolithic period onwards. During the later part of the Chalcolithic period, bullock carts and horse-drawn chariots also appear. Further, you will find that there is a predominance of male figures as compared to females. That means more figures of males have been drawn as compared to the females. So this was about the Chalcolithic age during Bhimbetka. And with this, our case study of Bhimbetka comes to an end. Now, let us look at the various colors and where they were obtained from. So, in all, there were 16 shades of colors used at Bhimbetka, including various shades of white, orange, yellow, red ochre, purple, brown, green and black. White and red were the most popular. They have been used the most often. Blue is important because it was absent. So, Bhimbetka ki paintings mein kaun sa color nahi mila hai? That is blue. In fact, prehistoric paintings mein blue color nahi mila hai. Why? Because it could not be obtained naturally. Achha, how were the colors obtained? By grinding rocks and minerals. So these were mineral colors. They were not plant pigments, right? Red has been obtained from hematite in soil. Hematite is a chemical compound known as iron oxide or ferric oxide. White has been obtained from limestone. Aap logon ne suna hoga, chuna jisko bolte hain, that is calcium carbonate. Yellow and green has been obtained from chalcedony. Chalcedony is a type of metamorphic crystalline quartzite rock. And black has been obtained from charcoal or burnt wood, right? So these were the sources of these colors. So most of them were mineral colors. Now the paint was not applied in a powder form. It was first mixed with water and then some sticky substance such as animal fat, gum or tree resin was added to it before applying to the rock surface. Why? Because it would adhere better to the rock surface. Brushes were made out of tree fiber and animal fur. Now, how is it that these paintings have not faded or been washed out over thousands of years? This was probably because of a process of natural oxidation of the pigment with the rock surface. Once any substance becomes oxidized, it is very difficult to reduce it or oxidize it once again. That would require tremendous amounts of energy, which are usually not available in a natural form, right? They have to be created under lab conditions. So, hence, it has been preserved. So, ये आपको clear हो गया होगा कि colors कौन-कौन से use किए गए हैं, more importantly, कौन सा color missing था, और ये जो colors हैं, कहाँ से obtain किए गए हैं. इस पे UPSC बहुत आसानी से कोई simple सा question पूछ सकती है. So, be careful and revise this carefully before going for the preliminary examination. Right. Moving forward, let us look at the prehistoric paintings of South India. So, three sites in South India, I believe I had mentioned earlier, these were Pitlihal, Tekkalkota and Kubgallu. Now, in South India, the paintings belong to the Neolithic context. Iske pehle South India mein paintings nahi exist karti thi, right? Three types of paintings have been identified on the basis of the color. First is the paintings in white. Second is the red ochre paintings over a white background. Iska matlab ye hai ki rock ko pehle white color se whitewash kiya jata tha, fir uske upar red ochre se painting banayi jati thi. And third is red ochre paintings. That is directly the color red ochre was applied on the rock. Achha. Now, these paintings have been found in the vicinity of megalithic burials. A characteristic feature of the Neolithic paintings in South India is that very elegant long-horned humped bull figures have been made. For example, the one you can see on your right. These paintings also give evidence of agricultural activities as well as bullock carts and horse-drawn chariots. So, this is all you need to know about the prehistoric paintings. On the basis of what we have read, I would like you to attempt a few questions with me. First question, which one of the following sites is famous for prehistoric paintings? A. Bagh, B. Ajanta, C. Bhimbetka or D. Amravati. So, ये तो बहुत आसान सा question है. इसका answer obviously C. Bhimbetka है. Discovered by whom? V.S. Wakankar. कहाँ पे है ये? Raisen district of MP. Within which wildlife sanctuary? The Ratapani wildlife sanctuary. Right? So, the answer is C. Bhimbetka. Next question, ACL Carlyle discovered prehistoric rock paintings at A. Bhimbetka, B. Sohagi Ghat, C. Bagor or D. Lakhudiyar. So, you must know the answer to this question as well. It is B. Sohagi Ghat. Where is it? In the Kaimur Hills, in the Mirzapur district of Uttar Pradesh. Right? So, don't forget this name. ACL Carlyle. He was the first person in India and the world to discover prehistoric paintings. Achha, next is a match the following questions. You have to match list 1 with list 2. List 1 is colors and list 2 is the material. So, list 1 contains of red, white, green and black. List 2 is charcoal, calcium carbonate, chalcedony and ferric oxide. So, red was obtained from ferric oxide, white was obtained from calcium carbonate, green was obtained from chalcedony and black was obtained from charcoal. So, the answer should be 4, 2, 3 and 1. So, the answer would be C. 4, 2, 3, 1. Right. Now, coming to the final question. It is asking you that which of the following statements is incorrect. 1. Mesolithic paintings at Bhimbetka depict a large number of metal-tipped weapons such as spears and arrows. 2. Mesolithic paintings at Bhimbetka suggest division of labor based on gender. 3. Humans are depicted in a naturalistic manner while animals have been shown stylistically in the Mesolithic paintings at Bhimbetka. And 4th, Paleolithic paintings at Bhimbetka depict a large variety of large and small animals. So you have to read the question very carefully over here. It is asking you which of these statements is incorrect, right? So let us see the first statement. That Mesolithic paintings at Bhimbetka depict a large number of metal-tipped weapons such as spears and arrows. So metal was not used during the Mesolithic period. It first appeared from the Chalcolithic period onwards. So the first statement is incorrect. Second statement, Mesolithic paintings at Bhimbetka suggest a division of labor based on gender. Yes, this is correct. Third statement, humans are depicted in a naturalistic manner while animals have been shown stylistically in the Mesolithic paintings at Bhimbetka. Iska bilkul ulta tha. Animals ko in a naturalistic manner dikhaya gaya hai while humans have been shown as stick figures, that is stylistically. So this statement is also incorrect. The fourth statement, Paleolithic paintings at Bhimbetka depict a large variety of large and small animals. ये गलत statement है. Paleolithic period में केवल large paintings of large animals बनाए जाते थे. Small animals were not shown. So the incorrect ones are 1, 3 and 4. The correct answer would be C. 1, 3 and 4 only. And that is the end of our lecture and these questions. Thank you very much for your patience and we will be back very soon with the next video of this series.